come on, Kerala. Come on, Kerala. Come on.
Good evening. We have today Dr. Sharafudheen, Vice Chairman of Kerala Chamber of Commerce. So, we are very glad to receive you here today, sir.
Thank you. Good evening to you.
We are proud to be here with you in this evening. So, we're going to have a short talk with Dr. Sharafudheen. As we are seeing about the campus crew, it's a global students organization, especially this, with the students, by the students of the universities in UAE. The main concept and idea behind this is to make the ideas into realities. We'll have the convergence of creative ideas here, and we'll have some forward steps in that. So, we could start from your childhood experience, and as a student, what made you to dream heights and to reach here?
Of course, as a student, if you ask me what has taken me to height, is my reading, because I was very passionate about reading of many books, articles, especially of certain areas. I had certain areas, certain passions in industries like advertisement, tourism, and service industry, and so on. So I used to read most of the articles which are available at that time from my school days itself. Especially I remember because the Reader's Digest is still most favorite magazine for me, because it has the contents of every interest. Especially if you want to promote yourself, if you want to know about an industry, the human values, everything that contains. Apart from that, of course, many articles which we used to get at that time has really helped me to build my, or to realize, as you said, to realize my passion into reality.
So we could say reading was the base of your success.
Of course, reading. Then, of course, my family was a business family. My father was doing business. Whenever I get leisure time, I used to be with him to learn what is business. And he used to lead me, he used to give me ideas, used to give me many, many lessons on that. That is also one of the key area which has helped me to grow up.
How do you evaluate your success? Because success will bring happiness. Are you happy now?
Certainly I'm happy. Because I've got a certain passion. I was aiming at certain goals which I could reach. And I am getting support from my family, my team, working team. I believe it's not a one-man show. It's a collective effort. Definitely that collective effort, that collective support were there with me throughout. I'm really happy because I could establish many streams of business and I could guide a lot of people. I have reached to the India national level in the Travel Association of India till the Vice President. Now I was the Kochi Chamber of Travel and Tourism President. Many areas, many accolades, of course, came to me. Show me I am successful.
So you are completely happy?
I am very confident, I am happy.
Okay. When coming to Kochi, it is the commercial hub of South India or Kerala now. So what do you think the future of the business in Kochi?
Kochi, of course, especially when focusing the industrial enterprise of the private entrepreneurs, definitely, Kochi has a very high potential, very good future, and a future consisting of in many areas. You know, Kerala is mainly not in manufacturing industry, but in service industry and other support industries. We do have a lot of support and service industries and major other industry like port, airport. These are things, and these are also increasing like anything. Like growing especially the Kochi airport, which is the fourth largest international traffic airport now in that region. And we do have now, of course, four airport will be there. Every 200 kilometers, now every 150 kilometers, we have airports. And Cochin has all the potential to grow industrially and commercially because of its strategic location, the logistics, logistical convenience, the connectivity, and the people around, of course.
When talking about the GST in India, what do you think, have it brought any good things or it made slow down the business in India?
Any financial changes in taxation or the policy definitely will give you a threat back, immediate threat back. But time goes on, naturally it will be corrected. Because the GST also, we have seen many corrections in GST, the process of the GST, even by the government. The 28% taxes, they have reduced 18%, 18% they have reduced 12%, 12% they have reduced to 5%. These are happening because of the reality in the market. So it is not the time to give a right comment about GST, because GST is not yet complete, I believe. GST, the fine-tuning of the GST has yet to come. So we need to wait for that, to have a comment on this. But any taxation, the single point taxation will definitely help us to help to grow the economy. There's no doubt. But the tax rate has really hit us, which will be corrected in due course of time.
As taking the count of population of India, it's vast. But something is lagging there. Business is not booming as per the population there, like China or something. So what do you think the reason is behind that?
I believe people power is a good thing for any growth. Population means more people. How? Because you are sitting in UAE. Huh? How there are a lot of Indians and a lot of Malayalis in UAE? What is the reason? One reason is, of course, we have got enough people. Enough people to go work out. Because there are employment problems, there are financial problems, but people are ready. Our people are ready to go out and work outside with loyalty, with trustworthiness. That's how, you got the Malayalis got acceptance, first of all. Once we got accepted, because we started spreading anywhere, even to US or to any remote places, whenever, because we are all traveling people, even in China, a place called Kunmin. I found a person who is working in a kitchen of one of the five-star hotel. He is the only Indian and he is Malayali. Kunmin is a very faraway place, very, very cold place. But still, the places like that, we are ready to work. We are ready to work, we are ready to earn money. So population is not a problem for us. But of course, the problem is to make all these people skillful. That is why the Skill India has got prominence. You would have heard of NSDC, National Skill Development Corporation, which has identified certain areas to make them skill in those areas, like tourism, IT, and a lot of other areas. They have identified certain areas in certain locations. And these locations and they are conducting classes also. The government is providing support to train these people. And once we are capable, we are successful in making these people skillful, definitely this population, the increased population or the enhanced population will not be a problem for us, but it will be worth for us.
Okay. Coming to a conclusion, what do you have your message to the new generation? Your message to the new generation.
My message is, of course, be skillful. But if you want to start a business, if you want to start something else, first of all, you learn about that. Knowingly, you get into that. Work for the achievement till you reach there. There is no rest. Because you won't fail. You never fail. But you stop trying. Don't stop trying. Keep trying. You will definitely succeed.
So we are concluding here. Thank you, sir. Thank you so much for your
Thank you very
time.
Much for the opportunity.
Come on, come on, Kerala.